glad to be here today. We're on the Big K Tree Farm. I'm here with Lynn Hooven. He is a registered forester and was the chief of forest management with the Georgia Forestry Commission. We're sitting in their outdoor classroom, which is on about 1,500 acres in Jones County. Big K Farms is owned by former Braves players, Ryan Klesko and John Smoltz. But before we talk about Big K, Lynn, I want to ask you about your career as a registered forester.
Okay. A lot of people ask me how I got, especially being a Yankee, coming from New Jersey, how in the world I got in forestry or got into forest in Macon, Georgia. I probably can attribute my career back to my Boy Scout days. I was always an outdoor person and was involved in Boy Scouts and became an Eagle Scout. And several of the most favorite badges I got were in forestry and soil water conservation and wildlife and such. And as a lot of you probably have already done or will do maybe somewhere in your one of your courses, you're going to have to write a paper maybe what you want to be. I'm one of those unique individuals. Had to write a career paper, what I wanted to be when I was in the ninth grade.
Wow.
And I selected forestry, and we had to go interview somebody that was in forestry, and that's what I did. And so that was maybe the seed that started all this. And then the reason I got transplanted to Georgia was for the forestry school. And long story short, I ended up going to the forestry school, and getting a degree in forestry, and voila. Well, as in any job, whether you are, whether you're in forestry, whether you're a doctor, whether you're a lawyer, whether you're a ditch digger or anything, you know, you hope it's not a job, it's a career. And that I started a career with the forestry in the field as a technician. And then if you, you know, hustle enough, the opportunity is there, and you want it, you follow your career path. And I did all along through Middle Georgia, different jobs as a said starting as a technician and a senior forester and a district forester, and then on staff in Macon, which is the state headquarters, and then associate chief and chief. So I went all the way from, you know, in the woods, you know, to heading all the programs up that had to do with forestry. My son went to University of Georgia. If I can put a plug in,
sure,
for him.
Yeah.
Went to University of Georgia and got a degree in horticulture. And still trees, plants, outdoors.
Yes.
And so he's, you know, he has a landscape design called Northern Lights. You may check it out in outside of Boulder, Colorado. But when you talk about careers, whatever career you go in, it makes no difference. I think you have to be flexible in what you do. You can't put all your eggs in one basket. And he now has Northern Lights Landscaping,
okay,
which is real nice. Now he has Northern Lights Exteriors, which is roof, siding, and gutters. Given the fact that the right now with housing down, well, his demand is down, but he still has it, still active, but he just expanded it a little bit, and that his business sense of the landscape design gave him enough savvy and enough business knowledge to start this Northern Lights Exteriors, and is doing very successful in that. But he's expanded, not dropping one. You have to be versatile, and you have to be willing to take a calculated risk. This economy is going to force you to adjust to whatever the need is out there. You can still have a career in whatever, agriculture, horticulture, hydrology, pathology, entomology, all the ologies. It'll force you to adjust to the demand and be creative in this world of careers.